A very good evening to all the dignitaries present on the dais and all my fellow companions. I, Soumya Jain, student manager of Sri Balaji Society, feels privileged to introduce you all the versatile personality, Mr. Dinesh Bhardwaj. Sir is HR professional with 17 plus years of experience in strategic HR, talent acquisition and management, business partner HR, and HR operations and change management. Sir gained his experience in corporate, manufacturing, pharmaceuticals, pre-engineering buildings, logistics, glass and ceramics with Japanese and American MNCs. Sir did his graduation in BSc Zoology Honours and did his Pgdm from Indian Institute of Management Technology, Chennai. Sir also did his MBA from Maharishi Dayanand University. Sir has worked with Penance Biotech Limited for 6 years, where he was awarded Star Performer of the Year. And then, sir moved to Interact Building Products, where he rewarded to do recruitment and selections without any cost. Later, sir worked with Honda Logistics Private Limited and Guardian Industries. Sir is presently working as Assistant Vice President HR at Mangalam Cement Ltd. And now, I call upon Dinesh Bhardwaj, sir, to share his knowledge and experience with us. Sir, the dais is all yours.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you very much for your patience, sitting since morning and listening. Very good experiences from head HRs. So I would like to clap everyone sitting over here. Why so? Because of your patience. Because I am not having so much patience to listen since morning till evening. I'll give you a clap in this regard. Why I said this? Because at present I am representing Mangalam Cement Limited. And my management knows that I'm over here. And I want to represent my company first. Then only company's value can come out of it. And even I have 5 guiding principles. And even I want these 5 guiding principles, everyone should understand what it is, so that even you can follow in your daily practices. First principle is discipline. Without discipline, no one can do anything. And if you are disciplined in all activities, whether it is social, whether you are going into your society, working wise, anything, discipline plays a vital role. Second is integrity. Integrity plays a vital role. Why? Because if anyone's integrity is doubted, that X or Y person shouldn't work in any organization. Third is compliances. Compliances, it sounds like every individual should be complied enough, whether it is related to PF, ESI, insurance, gratuity, anything. Fourth is value creation. What value I am adding to the business? Or what value you are adding to your institute while passing it on and going to any organization and working over there? What type of image you are giving to them? Fifth is ownership. Think that you are the owner of your organization, your work area, whichever work area you're working, whether it is HR, whether it is finance, whether it is IT. So these are the five guiding principles what I have implemented in Mangalam Cement Ltd. Now I would like to say something about the company. First of all, I would like to thank you for the institute to invite me over here. Secondly, the students sitting over here, thank you very much for your patience to listen my talk. Now, why I am over here and why everyone is sitting over here, the main thing is the guiding the way to the 21st century. The thought process, what it is, because I did my MBA 17 years back, thereafter I did my MPhil in human psychology from Loyola College. At that time, thought process was totally different, and now thought process is totally different. New technologies has come, and I have written something so that I'll share with you. How can school, college, institute continue to convert and relevant into the world of 21st century? We refine teaching for digital generation. Digital generation, why I told you? Because the time I was there, at that time, digitalization was not there, and now if anyone wants to understand, he can open his laptop or mobile services and he can understand that what is going on in this world. From this, every year in my company, I am hiring around 15 to 20 GETs and management trainees. And from them, not me, my entire team in the organization, they learn something from them. Learning in sense, we are working in one area, assembly line, in one silo, you can say. But you, as a youth, sitting over here, you're having very rich, innovative ideas in your mind, and that innovative ideas is required in industries these days. Adding to that, even the teachers, even the lecturers, and the professors, they are also time to time changing their thought process, how to educate the students. Because every year, company strategy is getting changed, and that strategies is not only made by the management people, it is the people sitting over here and the young generations. Why I am saying this? Because you all are having different ideas in your mind, and that ideas we are implementing in the plant or in corporate areas. ऐसा है कि मैं एयरपोर्ट पे बैठ के ये पूरी कहानी लिखाऊं. आई हैव रिटन 21st सेंचुरी में ऐसा होना चाहिए, ये होना चाहिए. क्रक्स में यही है कि एक दिन में रॉकेट नहीं बनता है. जितने भी एक्सपीरियंस्ड लोग हैं उनका भी थॉट प्रोसेस होता है. जो फ्रेशर्स आते हैं उनका भी थॉट प्रोसेस होता है. तो इट्स अ चेन. तो वी ऑल शुड वर्क टुगेदर सो दैट रिजल्ट विल कम आउट फ्रूटफुल. बिकॉज द टाइम आई वॉज वर्किंग इन होंडा, देयर आई सॉ माई बॉस. He was a Japanese. His name was Kawara-san. Kawara-san. He was married. But uska naam hi Kawara-san tha. San in sense, normally we say san as a G in Japanese. So that Kawara-san used to call me Dinesh-san, Bhardwaj-san. And the time I joined Honda as head of HR in Tapukada in Bhiwadi, ...15 days I was in the orientation process, and 16th day I went to his cabin. He said, I don't trust Indians. I felt very bad. मैं क्या गलत तो नहीं आ गया? मैं होंडा बहुत नाम सुना था इस कंपनी का. सेम वे व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस, बिकॉज आई एम शेयरिंग माय एक्सपीरियंस विद यू. सेम वे कैन हैपन विद यू, बिकॉज सारी कंपनी में आपको दिनेश भारद्वाज जैसे इंप्लॉय नहीं मिलेंगे. आई एम नॉट जोकिंग. नो नीड टू क्लैप. मैं इसलिए आपको बोल रहा हूं कि इवन आई एम सीइंग जीटीज मैनेजमेंट ट्रेनी कमिंग इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड सिटिंग आइडल फॉर द इंटायर वन ईयर डूइंग नथिंग. नो वन इज गिविंग देम रोल टू वर्क. क्या बोलते हैं, देखो क्या चल रहा है कंपनी में, वेदर इट इज ए कॉर्पोरेट, वेदर इट्स ए प्लांट, वेदर इट्स ए यूनिट. If you are campus placed in any industry, never get disheartened from this. Why so? Because you are totally fresher. No one will have that trust in you. I was having 10 years of experience, and the time I was when I joined Honda, my boss is saying that I don't trust Indians. What does it sound? You should think in a positive direction. And I worked there for 4 years. And that person sent me to Japan for 10 months. And after 1 year, he said that, yes, Dinesh, I trust you. And now you can go to Japan for 10 months with family and understand the way Japanese work. Same way, it applies to you also. The time you are getting opportunity in any organization, you should have patience in yourself. Understand the company and just try to create value out of it. Because your HOD, your respective department heads, they will say that why I have hired this person, whether I am getting fruitful result out of it or not. If that HOD will say that yes, he is getting fruitful result out of him, then only you can create value out of it. And how you can create? You need to open your eyes. You need to understand how the system is working. Since years to years, because if I talk about Mangalam, since 1978, it was established. At the time I came in, and if any freshers is coming in, any company, you need to understand how the company runs. From that only you can create value. And once that value is created, automatically trust will be created. You might be thinking that I don't have anything in my mind, but I am having n numbers of questions in my mind. I'm wondering that that question, if I'll ask anyone, whether I'll be getting that right answer or not. Maybe afterwards I'll be asking that question. Flexible and responsive learning conditions begin with growing your students in a learning-centered environment. This is the role of a teacher. The teacher will take on these stances. How to educate today's generation? Number one. Is it giving instructions to them? Collaborating. Facilitating students working together face to face or over distance. Recognizing the norms of collaboration among various cultures. Engaging in collaborating inquiries on projects that have meaning for learners. The role of a teacher, why I'm saying this? Because teachers need to change their concept of teaching these students, then only fruitful result will come out. Coaching them. Mentoring them. And in this 21st century, it is required. Because you are the next leaders and you need to stand where I am standing over here. You need to deliver results, then only company will grow in society and in the country. Saying this, why it is important? Because you all are totally freshers. You all are having very good, innovative ideas in your mind. Recently, I took around 5 management trainees in my department, HR department. And the time they submitted their report, it was really very excellent. And they asked me, sir, how is this report? I said it is okay. I didn't say that it's very excellent. What will happen next? Performance will go down. Same way, It applies to everyone. Never get disheartened if any organization is coming for the campus next year. Even I'll be coming for the campus over here. No need to clap. Then what will happen? I'll be at this side and you'll be at this side. Now it is totally different. The overall conclusion of this is, any organization wants smart employees, not hard worker. If any company wants hard worker, he can hire any 10th pass or 12th pass employee. You're doing your management. You should be smart enough in tackling the situation, dealing with the client, and you can understand what you mean by the smart worker. Now I'll tell about the top CEO, Mercer, KPMG. They had done research and their conclusion came, top CEOs from around the world were interviewed regarding skills for the future. Noteworthy in their feelings is a trend found in many discussions surrounding skills set for the future. Skills set for the future. What type of skills you're having? Because everyone sitting over here is having different skills. Knowledge everyone is having, but skills everyone is having different. And the candidates, whenever these CEOs they are interviewing, they are just checking their skills, ability, and how much smartly you are answering to their questions. This was the crux given by KPMG and Mercer. Employers are changing their recruitment and selection process. In short, employers expect adaptability, adapting the skills, new technologies, trends, and how smartly the answer the person is giving to the person. Smartly, it doesn't sound like kitna bevkoof bana raha hai. Whether he is having depth knowledge of that subject or not. Because the time I had gone to XLRI Jamshedpur and over there I had interviewed candidates. They were very good. Skill set. Very nice. But the time when we said that, kindly introduce yourself, he was shivering. I can understand that five fingers are not equal. But that guy, he was shivering. And the time we took his aptitude test, he scored around 95%. And do you know he was rejected. To try to improve in your body language, ability, communication skill, and how confident you are in answering to any questions. Securing marks, anyone can secure good marks. But how confidently you are delivering it, it matters a lot. Any organization, they want to see the results out of it. Whatever you are studying, that will be implemented in the plant or in the corporate world. Can you imagine, like, whatever you are studying, only 40% is implemented and 60% is just IQ, logic. 100% never applies in any organization, because we will not run any company in a theoretical way. Even you can't imagine that this will go like this, that will go like this. Never it will happen. It is all your thought process, how you are putting it into it, and what type of results will come out of it. Digital age has converted our world like never before. This connectivity requires solid foundation in core competencies of language, mathematics, and information and communication. However, it is the skills of the workforce that will determine the success of core knowledge, and where not only economy will grow accordingly. It was said by Ropel. Technology is rapidly changing our world. The amount of new technical information is doubling every 2 years. Every 2 years, the technology is getting changed. It's predicted to be double every 72 hours by 2018. Technology is no longer a way to simplify teaching, learning. Rather, it will implore result posting, transform teaching. Students today are digital learners. You might be thinking that hum log to digital hai. What next? Can anyone tell over here, after digital, what it will be? AI. Good. Everyone has done homework before coming over here. So Same used to apply at the time I used to give learning and development in my area over there. In my company, like earlier we used to call steam engine, 40 per speed. Electrical engine, 120 per speed. Then bullet train, 500. Who will make a rocket train over here? No one has heard over here. Maybe anyone sitting over here, they'll make a rocket train so that that speed will be 2,000 per kilometer. See, when you can imagine, why can't I imagine over here, standing over here? Is it possible or not? Yes, it is possible. Someone is saying that it's not possible, but I'm saying that it's possible. 100% it is possible, and you people can do it. Do you know one of our president, Mangalam Cement, he called GET and he said that what is the capacity of our plant? He said 3.5 metric ton. Then that president, he said, I want to see this plant in 4 lakh metric ton. Can you do it? And that plant is running since 30, 35 years. He's asking from that GET. And that GET was from Thapar, Patiala. Do you know what was his answer? Yes, I can do it. And at present, our plant is 3.75 metric ton. I'll clap for that GET. That GET, he did it. And that president who was sitting since so many years, he didn't do it. So what does it sound? That everyone is having competencies in them, only it is matter of delivering the result. And the way you deliver, automatically result will come out. And now that GET, I'm just talking about 3 years back of this organization. He's working as project manager. And every project manager in any organization, he is getting promoted after 5 years, but he got after 2 years project manager. Thinking different. Whatever you do, do it in a different manner and with a positive approach. This applies. Why in a positive approach? Because result will come out. 100% result will come out if you will do it in a positive manner. One thing I want to tell you, someone might have gone through WhatsApp also. If you plus knowledge, K plus N plus knowledge, that is around 92%. The time you plus money, it comes around 96%. And the time you plus attitude, it comes 100%. Attitude matters a lot. If you think positive, 100% result will be positive. These are the small tips why I'm sharing with you. because in my career I have done this, and I want my experience to get shared with you, because positive things will never get collapsed. The time you will think negative 100%, that arrow will come back to you. Think in a positive direction, result will be 100% positive. Education for the future. Guiding principles is the foundation upon which we are building our ramp of the future. First principle, the world is flat. Try to understand. First principle, the world is flat. Second, 21st century fluences, solution, information, creativity, media, collaboration. Third principle, strategic choice. Fourth principle, personal learning environment. These are the principles for the 21st century. Fifth principle is real, relevant, and responsive. Finally, community. The way you take in, the way you take out. Conclusion of this is educators and students need to work together to refine institute and what institute system could be. We need to explore together. We need to imagine the possibilities. The future is not certain, but the need for change is. What we know is that this new definition of institute involves co-learning and co-creativity. We must embrace what we know about the learners being shaped by the digital age. Research and common sense tells us we need to learn from our learners, teachers, professors, and your own IQ. Crux of this is basically coming from old thought process to the new thought process is the way you shape your knowledge. The output you will be getting in that manner. I'll be closing my session. See, everyone sitting over here is having knowledge. And kindly try to use that knowledge in a positive direction. That's why I'm focusing in the positivity side. Because the time you'll be thinking positive, 100% result will be coming out. Think positive, result will be positive. And try to improve in your personality, creativity, and whenever any company is coming, try to go through the concept, vision of that company, and what company is it into, and what type of candidate they are looking for. Thank you again. Thank you so much for your patience and listening my words. And even thank you to Dean and Director and Assistant Director, Deputy Director, and the senior person sitting over here. Thank you so much for calling me right away from Rajasthan. I have come over here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for sharing with us the five guiding principles of life, which are discipline, integrity, compliances, value creation, and ownership. Sir, you told us about the importance of redefining teaching for the digital age. We have learned that we can create value only by learning how the company works, and that is how we would be able to create trust. Thank you once again, sir, for sharing your experiences with us.